now at 11.
It hits me pretty hard. I mean, it's my kid's life in danger.
Police say they found a school bus driver drunk behind the wheel right after dropping off students.
This horrible noise happened.
This was no tornado. What cut a path of destruction through a tiger neighborhood?
And later, we'll see who finds themselves unlucky on the field in this Friday the 13th edition, Friday Night Flights.
Good evening on this Friday, and we start with breaking news. We are monitoring out of Seattle. A triple shooting there has closed a public transit station.
We do know one person is dead. Two others have been hurt. This happened near the downtown Westlake Light Rail station. The shooter has not been arrested, and there's no word yet on a motive.
And now to a story that is outraging parents in Longview. That's where police arrested a school bus driver for a DUI.
It happened just minutes after the driver took two busloads of kids home. KGW's Catherine Cook, just back from Longview. She talked to police. She talked to the district officials as well, Catherine.
Well, Dan, no kids were on the bus during the arrest, and no one was hurt. And for that, the district is grateful. So are parents. But they're also angry and asking, what if?
At the Longview School District's bus yard, the Transportation Department's mission statement says to support the educational program by safely transporting students. On Friday, parents learned police arrested a woman on suspicion of driving a Longview school bus while under the influence.
As a parent, you know, I couldn't imagine being, you know, having kids on a bus with somebody that had been drinking.
It hits me pretty hard. I mean, it's my kid's life in danger.
Longview police say around 4 o'clock Thursday, someone called 911 to say the bus driver looked intoxicated. Dispatchers contacted the Longview School District, which got the bus driver to stop on Nichols Boulevard. That's where police found 48-year-old Catherine Macaron, who they say smelled like intoxicants.
This incident we take very seriously, and our number one priority is safety and security for our kids.
District spokesperson Rick Parrish says no students were on the bus during the arrest, but just half an hour earlier, there were. First, students from R.A. Long High School, then kids from Northlake Elementary. Police tell us more than 90 students may have been on board during Macaron's two afternoon routes. They're contacting all of them as part of their investigation.
Oh, we're extremely grateful that all the kids are okay.
Parrish says the district is working closely with police during their investigation. In the meantime, they've placed the driver on leave from her job. One parent say they can only trust is done with their kid's safety in mind.
And that's a huge responsibility for that driver to take, and it's terrifying.
Macaron was booked into the Cowlitz County Jail for DUI and reckless endangerment. More charges could follow. The district says depending on its investigation, the driver could be fired. Dan.
All right, Catherine, thank you so much. We want to tell you now about another suspected driver under the influence. This person left a path of destruction in Tigard today. You see some of it behind me here. Police say a woman plowed through several yards, and now she's facing a number of charges, including possession of meth, DUII, and hit and run. KGW's Mike Benner gives us a look at the damage left behind.
It's really insane.
Insane is one way to describe what happened outside Philip Georgiev's house Friday morning. Frightening is another.
I thought it's the fireplace because, you know, there's a gas line there, and I thought maybe that's what exploded because it sounds like it. The whole house shook.
What sounded like an explosion was a car crashing through a fence and taking out an entire exterior wall of Georgiev's home.
If we had our bedroom back here, if not badly injured, probably, I don't know, dead. It's terrible.
And take a look at what happened to the house next door. Debris from this crash shattered the glass slider that was right here. And what's terrifying is that a woman and her little girl were asleep right inside. We can tell you that both of them were unharmed physically, but definitely shaken up.
This all happened in Tigard, near the intersection of Southwest Hall and McDonald. Authorities tell us a woman, under the influence of something, veered off the road and plowed through several properties, eventually coming to a stop on a retaining wall.
This horrible noise happened, a terrible alarm clock. Yeah.
Georgiev woke up, ran outside, and approached the car.
And then I thought, I hope there's not a dead person in there, because that's the worst, you know, seeing blood and who knows what. But there was nobody in there. So
the driver ran from the scene, but was found two blocks away. We're told she was combative towards police and medics, but ultimately taken into custody.
The best thing is that nobody's really injured.
Georgiev, who moved into his house only 2 months ago and finished painting it Thursday, is now cleaning up the mess.
Our life is going to change for the next, I don't know, couple of months until this is all finished.
Mike Benner for KGW News.
A touching ceremony on the field at Kelso High School tonight. The school retired the jersey of their former player turned Cowlitz County deputy, Justin DeRozier. Number 73 will never be worn again in Kelso. DeRozier was shot and killed in the line of duty back in April. Tonight's game honored not just him, but all law enforcement. Many local officers lined the field tonight, and fans donned blue and black colors. DeRozier played offensive and defensive line for Kelso. He graduated in 2008. Current head coach Steve Amerine didn't know him, but has felt his impact.
A fun-loving kid, just loved Kelso, loved being a Highlander, loved our community, loved giving to our community. And you know, that's from our staff members.
Oh, he was just a bright, highly motivated young man.
That was Sheriff Brad Thurman. Tonight, he presented the team with a sketch of DeRozier you see here done by a Seattle artist. It will now hang in the halls at Kelso High School, right next to the number 73 jersey.
So it has been 6 months to this point since a Columbia County teenager went out for a walk and never came home. Investigators today say they still do not know what happened to 18-year-old Sarah Zuber. Her body was found alongside a rural road outside of Rainier. It was her sister, of all people, who came across the body, just feet away from the family property. We're told Zuber was an avid walker and she had gone out for a walk the night before. That's the last time anyone saw her. Zuber was homeschooled, but she ran cross country for Rainier schools and had hoped to go to Portland State. The Zuber family released an emotional statement today. It was sad and poetic, and it reads in part, "At times the grief is unbearable. So much so that only a groan escapes my airway and the tears flow unceasingly through the lonely night." If you have any information that might help investigators figure out what happened to Sarah, call the Columbia County Sheriff's Office.
Just as I was rolling forward from my last stop to the next stop, I noticed the small boy on his bicycle come up past the front side of the bumper on the truck, and I knew what was going to happen.
A local garbage truck driver's attention to detail may have helped save a little boy's life. The two-year-old was on a bike in his neighborhood in Happy Valley. At the same time, the boy's dad was backing out of the driveway. That's when Jeff Jones saw the father hit the boy on the bike. He ran up screaming and yelling to make sure the father knew to stop. Then he helped him get his son from underneath the truck. The toddler suffered broken bones and some cuts, but this could have been much worse.
I'm pretty sure the bike took some of the force of the truck from off of him. Everything happened so fast, and when we got him off, it was just a big pile. I was literally 3 feet from the child.
Jones says drivers with waste management are trained to always be watching for what's around them at all times. He's planning on visiting the little boy and his family this weekend after the boy is released from the hospital.
Ooh, hope he makes a full recovery.